So, all to you, Dr. Shyam Sundar.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Good afternoon, everybody.
This is Dr. Shyam Sundar. Good afternoon.
Yeah, here I would like to share.
One minute, doctor. Can we all mute ourselves, please, so that he is done with his thing to do a proper job and you're not disturbed? Thank you. Dr. Jaya, may I request you, please?
Can
Yes,
I?
sir, go ahead. Yeah.
Yeah. Good afternoon once again. I think everybody in this group of teaching professionals, that's what I made this, you know, do's and do nots of a teaching fish, which I mean that a teaching professional. While swimming in the pool, that means while teaching, what are the do's and do nots we need to follow? This is all about, I collected the data right from the year 1994. I used to write in my diary whatsoever the things I need to do, and I observed through my teaching experience and exposure. So that I have collected some data by referring books and also whatsoever I have written in my diary right from the year 1994. I hope a majority of you, all of you are teaching professionals, right? Can you mention that?
Yes, sir.
Any other?
Yes, sir.
Majority of you are teaching professionals. So that, before going to start that, you know, what is this teaching profession? Teaching is a kind of, you know, honorable position in society. Wherever you go, a good teacher is similar to a similar like a candle that consumes itself to light up others' paths, others' lives. So this is what I would like to highlight after all these possessing about 24 years of experience and different kinds of experiences with fellow teaching fraternity and society. All these things I have, whatsoever I have got experience, I compiled that particular data and also I prepared this PPT. And of course, I delivered this PPT with many updates in different sessions in different colleges for faculty development programs, in-house and out-house also. So that I'd like to start with that. A beauty of teacher is to make complex things to the simple, especially for the students' community. A teaching profession is an ideal profession among all. So teaching is the one profession that creates all other professions. So teaching professionals will make others as well. So before going to start with this, what are the do's and do nots of teaching professionals? Particularly, we need to know that we can have a glance of it. First of all, teaching professionals should have this particularly highly self-disciplined and practice yoga and meditation daily. Because of, you know, by practicing yoga and meditation, one can become the brain strong. That means here, that is physical device, and mentally able person. That means a yogic person, the person who will practice meditation and yoga every day, that will boost up mind and body. Body will be stronger, mind will be stable, and a stable mind will have able mind. So that is the reason. Not only a teaching professional, especially for teaching professional, it is mostly required because of we need to face so many hurdles and varieties of mentalities among the students' community. So that is the reason we need to have practice, more and more practice on yoga and meditation every day. Because different varieties of people we need to come across never having any kind of BP, temperament or anything else, any personal kind of things we need to avoid. That means a kind of yogic person, as you all know that right from Nalanda, Takshashila universities, the teachers used to be like that. And carry your pen always with you, because I saw so many people, the moment we entered the institution, majority of the, almost I have seen that 70% of the faculty will not have a pen at all with their pocket. So that I observed that a pen is a weapon to the pen and paper, or weapon to the teaching professional. Pen, of course, it is mostly required, first of all. And we must be like a model personality in the institution and society. So that means, model means here, we must create our own brand image among all the colleagues and in the institution and also in society. That means we need to follow certain standards when you have possessed. So almost 20 years of teaching in engineering technological institutions, I observed that, you know, majority of the people will come for teaching professional, especially non-arts and humanities, you know, science and basic science and humanities will come to teaching profession with passion, whereas the technical faculty may not come with passion. So majority, I say, that is my opinion that I observed. So that's what I am commenting. It's not a negative comment. I'm saying that, you know, majority of the technical faculty will come for teaching, not like a passion towards teaching. As a secondary profession, they may treat sometimes, you know. And, you know, the other point I would like to talk about, advise the students in an indirect manner. While dealing with the students, we need to advise the students in indirect manner. Now, that means here you are an idiot, you are not hard worker, we should not say like that. And simply by saying indirect manner, we need to advise. I know that you can read well. Simply instead of telling like this, read well. Don't say read well. And I simply by adding one statement in that part, you know, I know that you can read well like that. That means here the students will understand his own ability. And also dress code of a teaching professional is also equally important, because the first impression is the best impression, as you all know that. And well-dressing, effective and impressive way of talking should be honorable. That means here when your colleagues are passing by, that, you know, whenever they are passing by saying that, you know, you need to appreciate, you have good dressing and effective and impressive way like that. When you motivate the fellow teaching friend, teaching professionals, so they will get a good kind of impression, and everybody will understand your attitude and behavior, the way we dress. That means here, attire is very much important for having a kind of impressive look when talking to each other or something. And the next point, you know, encourage the students who have exhibited their talent and excellence, and clapping by all the remaining students. Suppose when you want to, somebody answer, one student has answered correctly with a self motivation. Whoever the student is exhibiting his talent or her talent and excellence, we need to ask the remaining students to clap to motivate the student, and understand before understanding the students and try to control your weaknesses. So sometimes we are all human beings. Sometimes we may have some kind of weaknesses, but we need to understand before understanding the students, and also try to control our own weakness, whatever the weakness we may have. And teachers should be pioneers, but not settlers. That means here we should switch over to from one position to another position by updating our own knowledge, by updating the latest techniques and trends with the technological devices to be utilized. not like, you know, the traditional way of teaching, not like settlers. If you are like settlers kind of teachers, the profession may not be interesting. Moreover, we will get more disappointed. And an ordinary teacher makes extraordinary students sometimes. Because you know, we might have seen some of our teachers, they may not be extraordinary, but they will be ordinary teachers, but they will make the students extraordinary. As you all know pretty well about that, our students will become highest positions and securing their life in such a way, better than our life, and a lifestyle and everything, whatever you understand. And first of all, for this, even though we are ordinary or extraordinary teachers, we need to try for making the students extraordinary. So when does it happen? When you run behind quality, that means with the quality of teaching, by updating ourselves, automatically quantity will come running behind you. That means the quantity means in the sense name and fame, good recognition, and also money, monetary benefit, everything. The quantity will come running behind you when you run behind quality. We need to run after quality, then automatically quantity will run after you. So this is what I observed from my 24 years of experience. We need to maintain such a kind of quality. That means we need to give the proper inputs to the learners that automatically on the very same day after immediate lecture is over, we will get the best feedback and appreciation and respect, everything, whatnot. So let us see that some other points I would like to talk about. Do's, update your knowledge. That is what I told you. We need to update knowledge day by day. If you do not update your knowledge, if you do not update your latest trends, you will be outdated teacher. So if you want to be updated teacher, you need to update knowledge and update the latest gadgets, latest system. That means, as you all know that after this lockdown, every one of us have come to know that how to inculcate the trend setting, how to habituate the online teaching process. And be sportive all the time. And broad-mindedness, we should have broad-mindedness while dealing with the superiors and inferiors, that means our subordinates, and also students. We must be very much sportive and broad-minded. And we need to update our knowledge by reading newspapers daily without fail. That means in every class, every day, we need to add the latest updates when we read newspapers early in the morning. We can add that point while delivering our lecture on that particular day. So that means here that the information may not be reached, may not be read by all the students, so that we can update their knowledge as well. And updating ourselves is very necessary to be alive. That means, as I would like to talk about this point, you know, it is all about technical society now. It's all inbuilt technological devices we are equipped with. So that, of course, technology will not substitute teachers. There is no doubt at all. Undoubtedly, I can say that you can read any article, you know, even in the latest news, technology cannot replace the teacher. So that is what we need to update. We need to update ourselves. We need to update ourselves. That is very much necessary to be alive as a teaching professional, and possess commitment on duty as teaching professional. That means when we commit to teaching profession, we need to have that kind of passion towards teaching profession, and encourage and inspire the students to participate in cultural activities, literature, debate, and quiz contests. To motivate the students and encourage the students to participate all varieties of activities, cultural activities, literature, debate, and quiz contests. And also here, the point is that when a student is in wrong direction, when a student is in wrong direction, try to convince him or her to follow the right direction. We need to be like a mentor. We need to be like a mentor and also guide to make them in the right direction, in the right path. And how and why and when, where, how, these are all the things they will inquire. We need to guide them in such a way. That means here, we need to create a kind of belief and trust on us. Then automatically every student, at least 40 to 60% of the students will follow our guidelines. So because of, when do they follow? When we are very much frank, that means we need to be frank, open-minded to understand every student. We need to forget about the home environment. We need to forget about home, what you can say, whatever the personal life, we need to forget when we are doing our job. And be punctual to your duties, and wish your colleagues in the first meeting every day in respectful manner, which connects and recognizes your mannerism. Of course, nowadays, after Corona lockdown, everybody started Indian tendency to wish the people like this. So automatically, people will habituate the right system. And when we are punctual towards our duties and also wishing all the colleagues whenever we meet in the first meet every day in a more respectful manner, automatically that will connect the people and recognizing our own mannerism. We will get proper recognition with our mannerism. So let us move on to the next slide. And in what way we need to make the students, when you see this, the teacher and parents are like two wings of a bird. The bird means here a student. A student has to get success. That means teachers and parents are like two wings of a bird, that is student, two wings of a student. If the student wants to get success, that means we are making them good citizen and good community, so that the students have to be a successful people in society, in their community, so that the teachers and parents are like two wings. So two equally well. So I think you might have seen this education. It takes three people here. If you want to make the student, if you want to make good community, good society, these three are very much important here. Student, that means here, student is taking support from parents and teachers to be the best citizen in the country. So it is all about 25-25-25. That means overall society and country. And we should be like a guide sometimes spiritually and community growth. And must be a loyal person to the organization. We must be very much trustworthy towards the organization. And we must be regular and punctual towards primary and secondary duties as well. So in addition with the primary teaching, if somebody may say that, I am very much strict to only teaching. I don't want to involve any other duties apart from teaching. If you say like that, that may have a kind of negative impression. So that related to teaching and other than teaching, administration side also we need to take up sometimes some roles. And if opportunity is not knocking at the door, search or create a new door for yourself. So when you are trying for getting an opportunity, we need to search for that and create a new door for yourself. And the next thing is, if you want to get achieve success in our teaching as well, we must be, we must be a patient listener. When the students raise some doubts, we need to be attentive listener. And when you are talking to the students, when they are raising the doubts in the class, we need to be attentive listener. And when we are talking to the fellow employees, fellow professionals also, we need to listen more. When you have more patience towards listening, no doubt there will be success in your favor. Always try to act as a role model with your right behavior, right attitude, and implement as if a model teacher, as if an ideal teacher. Always you must try to act as a role model. That means you need to be in such a way to implement with the right behavior, right attitude in front of everybody. It is not like naturally we must be like that. And respect your senior. Suppose, when you are respecting colleagues, in an artificial manner, when you pretend like a role model, automatically people can identify. Nobody is that much of dull people or weak people to observe, Everybody everybody is quite active and quite clever to identify if you pretend. So that never ever try to pretend, but be a natural teacher as a role model. And respect your senior colleagues also. And there is no substitute or shortcut for hard work, and especially in education. There is no lift system for education. Everybody should do hard work smartly. And let us move on to the other slide, that is, praise the real ability of your colleagues and students. When you start praising, not flattering, of course, we need to praise the real worth of the fellow colleagues, our own colleagues, and also students. We need to appreciate the real ability of the colleagues, real ability of the students. Then automatically you will get good impression among all. So that, be interactive with everybody in the institute from monitoring to from the morning to the evening without any hesitation. No temperaments or something. Never lose patience right from the morning till the evening. Be specific while informing any message either to your seniors or subordinates. Possess empathy. That means respect, accept others' opinions as well. Never argue. And be specific while informing any message. Specific, sweet and short message you need to pass on either to your seniors or subordinates. And along with the possessing of the quality of empathy. And please follow these three best principles. When you follow these three best principles, you will be a successful teaching professional. And try to be happy and make others happy all the time. And the third and the second principle that I follow every day, all these three principles, that I never welcome troubles. If you welcome troubles, what happens, So the second principle that help others at your best, but never try to harm others at any circumstances. At any circumstances, never try to harm, even if it is enemy sometimes. And live and let live others to lead your life peacefully and happily with sound and healthy body and mind. We need to let live others to lead our life peacefully and happily with sound and healthy body and mind. So let us move on to the next slide. What are the other things we need to have? Well, let us have the best command over. Let us possess good command over, the best command over, perfect language skills with enough fluency. Along with the fluency, we need to have good command over English language. So not like blah, blah language. Use only formal communication while dealing with your higher authorities. And semi-formal communication may be used with your colleagues whenever required. Here are some useful web URL links to enhance your communication skills, which will give you better chances to secure promotions at your workplace too. What are those? We need to be internet savvy and techno savvy to update our communication skills, communicative competency in English language, in your particular specific language, whatsoever the language you require. So that, there are so many free resources to support your online learning. That means I'll share the one slide here. All web URLs to upgrade and update your communicative competency in English. Sorry, I'm moving on to next slide immediately. I don't know. Yeah, this is the slide, you know, to update and getting good command over English language, you need to
Doctor,
have, yeah, please.
Doctor, can I intervene, please? Okay,
yeah, please,
next
please.
5 minutes, next yeah. 5 minutes, you'll have to wind up, please.
Yeah, yeah.
Let, okay, thank you.
I completed till now do's, and for don'ts, I will move on at faster pace to complete in 5 minutes. Okay, ma'am?
Okay, please wind up. Thank you.
And let us see that. Do not surf teaching professional. Never use informal communication while dealing with your higher authorities. As I told you, formal communication is more required while dealing with the senior and higher authorities. Never be a monarch in the class and in society and with fellow beings and with fellow colleagues. Yeah, now, never be a monarch and no more individual discriminations. No individual reservations among your friends and students. And no smoking along with students. And some teaching professionals may be habituated to smoking and some other bad habits, but never ever exhibit those kind of bad habits like smoking and all. And better not to have that habit, if at all, if you have any kind, because I saw one faculty used to go to his room and smoke a cigarette every 1 hour once. So that is really not good for teaching professional. And taking or borrowing money or any other goods like cell phones from students, that also I observed in my one of the years of experience, you know, by some of the faculty. They used to take students' phones and students' things and all. That is really, that will give you bad impression on you. And no more corporal punishment, no physical punishment at all. And don't force your individual interest on students. You may have your own individual ideas, but you know, the individual interest should not be forced by the fellow employees and also fellow students. And they may be like atheistic or individual opinion. So that is the reason they are like sensitive case. So that don't insult physically or mentally challenged students like deaf and dumb, PSC, etc. Never insult any student whoever will have their physical problems. And do not contemplate on the family issues like problems, quarrels, etc. Never ever reveal the problems, our own problems, our family problems, family issues or anything else. Never contemplate. When you are doing our duty, we need to put effort, especially on duty itself. And do not insult the slow learners in front of other students. You need to talk to the particular slow learner and encourage him individually. And do not, while encouraging individual also, do not touch the sensitive issues. Do not talk about sensitive issues. No, family issues and all. Never entertain such kind of things. Only in academics we need to talk about. And do not spare much time on one particular student all the time. Because I saw some of the teaching professional by sparing half an hour to 1 hour one particular student in the working time. That is not correct, actually. And do not increase your BP levels at any cost. And don't follow teacher-centered method of teaching always. Teacher-centered approach will no more survive. And do not attack the person if you have any problem with him or her, but attack the problem. That is the best policy. Attacking the problem is more important than attacking the person. And you know, do not comment on your colleagues in front of your students and other colleagues, because that is called, you know, back talk. Loose talking in front of others. That is not correct, because negative impression will be improved when you have loose talk or commenting on in front of others about somebody. So don't forget that you are a counselor. Never forget that you are a counselor. You must be always like a counselor. And don't hesitate while teaching and dealing with students. And don't be in touch with students physically, but spiritually at UG level. And don't spare much time with a particular student always, as I mentioned this point already. And some other don'ts, don't be hypocrite. Don't be hypocrite all the time. And never, never be hypocrite. And do not hesitate the student's queries. And do not show any kind of negligence in giving. So do not show any kind of negligence in giving the information or in giving the assignment and the correction, evaluation. Never show any kind of negligence, even for correcting. Somebody will not correct the paper and all, even in assignment, they will directly assign the marks by having individual reservations. That is incorrect in the teaching professionals. And do not comment negatively about other colleagues in their absence, because no lose talking about others. Automatically it will go on like anything. Never try to violate ethical values of teaching profession and society. Let us move on to the final slide, I think. Never discriminate on religion, regional, racial, because they are all sensitive cases, sensitive issues. And do not talk about your subject is greater than others. Never try to increase your BP levels while interacting with others. Yeah, the last but one. While interacting with other students and colleagues, never ever increase the BP levels. Never try to insult or quarrel with others at any cost or under any circumstances. Because some of the politicians will do like that in a very immature manner, but we are all educated people. We should never lose our temperament. We should never insult or quarrel with anybody in the working environment. And don't be isolated from others, and don't be reserved. Never too isolate, never be reserved. Suppose, when you have the sound of your television at home, only zero, that is very much danger. We cannot listen to anything. If it is 70 to 90 or 100 sound, we cannot listen. So that I am asking you, now, don't be isolated from society, from others, and don't be reserved. And finally, any more questions? And before going to ask queries, do utmost justice to your chosen profession, because your profession will give you life and will give you utmost satisfaction when you try to do utmost justice. And get acknowledged as role model, role guide, and the best mentor in your society. Yeah. Any more questions, please? Can I get to know the questions?
Yes, if anybody has anything to ask, please unmute yourself and speak.
Yeah, you can unmute, ma'am, please. Hello? Any more questions on my session?
Any questions?
Dr. Shyam, no questions, but it is awesome work in explaining all this. It reminded me of my guru, who I respect a lot. Literally, he follows almost every bullet point of this presentation. Thank you for sharing that.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Said, can you hear me?
Yeah, please.
Very good afternoon. I think your session was really, really very important and very, very ethical in terms of how should we deal, especially with the student fraternity. I think amazing session. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. And you are most welcome.
Good afternoon,
sir. Gauri
here.
Yeah, Gauri, ma'am.
Yeah, congratulations. The session was really awesome, very insightful. And I think all these do's that you mentioned about is a reflection of your personality. It has come out really well. And from this presentation, I could really understand your personality.
thank you so much, ma'am.
That was really good. Awesome, sir. Thank you so much for this insight.
Actually, teaching is my passion. That is my vocation.
Yeah, and it came out in your presentation. Yeah, that came out in your presentation very well.
Yeah, my avocation is about two qualities. That is to deliver PDP and FDP lectures. And also, through that yoga and meditation, I used to deliver lectures on health tips.
Great, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, I would like to say something.
Yeah,
this
please.
Is Utsya here.
Yeah, ma'am.
Sir, you have fine-tuned a very important point, which we at times miss because we are so deep in only deliverables and our targets and, you know, the assignment which is given to us. But these are the small tips, but very important to us. Like when you said, don't get too much friendly to your participate and there will be a loose talk. So these are the very important thing at times we miss, because when we get close to the participant or the student, so we started sharing so many things.
Yes, ma'am.
So that we have to keep our level one step high, so that we should always project ourselves that, okay, people can mirror us, people can learn us, we will be the motivator for the students. Yeah. And the participant. So that was very good thing. We got fine tune and we got one spark. Okay, that we will always keep in to-do list, that these are the to-do list which we have to follow when we come to our work. It was nice, sir.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your best compliment.
You're welcome, sir.
You can go to my timeline. I have so many collected videos in Facebook on these different areas.